everybody, welcome for episode 11 of the Minecraft Let's Play with Junk. So I'm going to take you guys for a little tour. I've been doing nothing but constant daily work. So I'll let you guys check that out. Let me sleep the night so my villagers don't die. Alright, let me in. See, I've been doing a lot of work in the nether. I tried to record some of it, but it was painfully slow. But I saved a big chunk of it for a big time lapse, so that should be pretty cool if I can ever figure out how to do that correctly. But so far, I've completely mucked it up quite a bit. So yeah, last time we built the horse stable there, that works out pretty good. I got the horses moved, and now I can start building a little market area here. I want to get at least like one of each or a bunch of the villagers that I use to trade with often in a little village over there. But other than that, this right here, working out pretty good. I got a chest here now, I got the armor and saddles that I can find in there. But let's go to the main event in the nether. I started out slabbing and then that wasn't working out. It was just too open and, you know, too many pieces dangling around. That slabbing them all was getting to be a pain. So I ended up just digging out a massive chunk of the nether. Ow! Not nice. So yeah, as you can see, I've dug a lot. And then I got my horse path here. This took a lot of work, but well worth it. Ready? I love this. It's open and it, you know, gas fireballs can hit you, but I still love it. I want to work more on this. Get it going the rest of the way there. Still got a lot of digging to do. I'm limited by how much stone I have left. I'm going to have to figure out a better way. I dug a huge tunnel underneath the village there to try to get all the stone for this. But I may use more of the nether rack because I got... or a bunch of the nether brick because I'm getting a lot of it from over here. And then I've started setting up a farm here. It's not very big yet. It's only got one spawn layer. And then I set up this thing here to try to catch any gas because I had some gas spawn down there. And I still got to get some dogs so dogs can take care of the wither skeletons. I can get some wither skulls off of this. Turn this off so my brain can quit suffering. There we go. So yeah, been working on this. This is actually my third time building something here. So as far as making videos, I haven't been doing very good. I built two different types. One was just like I had portal set up here and pretty much just they would only spawn one block next and then the pistons would push them into the portal and then they would go to the overworld, but for some reason because of the size of the portal that I put here was so long that it would spawn them in different portals and I had to have like five different killing setups on the other side. But yeah, so getting all this, I got plenty of netherrack that I don't think I'll ever go through. Yeah, we got probably 20 chests here of netherrack, and that's a small portion of what I dug out. I mean, you think about digging out this much of the nethers, it took a few days, but it really wasn't that bad. I mean, slabbing it versus digging it out. I like digging it out because now we got this big open space to play with. I still need to do more that way and more that way, but all in good time, I guess. So yeah, I got some stone left over, a couple more redstone. I'm gonna have to get some more stuff here if I want to continue on, because I want to expand this and put more layers on it. Just haven't really had time. I just got this done yesterday. And then villager found his way in here. What kind are you? You're a Fletcher. You're completely useless to have here. Congratulations. So yeah, see, this is the only problem. Is those guys. Because he can hit me. I'm thinking what I'm going to end up doing is I'll put like a half slab wall around the place. I think that'll help a lot because they can't spawn in here. There's no areas I've excluded all spawning but on the platform. And that's one of the advantages digging out. And the only bad thing about this is I can't run across there unless I parkour it. I'm not even going to try that because I know how bad I am at parkour. Are you going to shoot at me? Nope, you're friendly? So yeah, I'm thinking a half slab wall around the sides will work out pretty well. I'll show you what I'm talking about a little bit. Put in here. So yeah, spawn here, the rates are pretty good. I'm getting a lot of gold from, well, probably not a lot of gold. You know, a little bit. Yeah, quite a bit of gold. It's working out good. As far as like an AFK gold farm, that's okay. So yeah, let's... Oh, don't we have some of these? Yeah. So yeah, a couple things that I tried out. I tried, you know, just pretty much it was just the portal and then every available, like every third block was open so that things could spawn, you know, wither skeletons could spawn there and then get sent to the overworld. Okay, I'm going to set you over here. Don't run and die in anything. But that was just problematic because they kept spawning in weird places and it just wasn't working out. So yeah, what I'm thinking about doing is just like this. All the way up to the ceiling and all the way around. Which I don't think it would be too bad to do. And I mean, I don't think I'm ever going to run out of nether brick. Most of the stuff that I mined out of here, I just burned or just let despawn just because I don't see me needing. I mean, I've got 20 chests, 20 doubles full of netherrack. I don't think I'm ever going to use any more than that. And if I do, it's not that hard to dig. So yeah, and it probably would have been easier just to go on top of the nether, but I'm trying to stay away from going on top of the nether. Because I think that's kind of cheaty up there. I'm okay with digging out and taking the time to do all the work. That's part of the fun of the game is, you know, like, it may have took a long time to dig this out, but now I can sit here and I can look at it like, yep, it's working out pretty good. But yet this the nether fortress went pretty much all around me here. You know, like there's some bits still there. And then on the other side over here, by the portal, there's actually more. I'm hoping to catch ghast so I can put the ghast in like the little chandelier things and just have those around in here. I think that'll be neat. But yeah, see if we can see it. There's actually more nether fortress that away. I don't think I can see any of it. Go away, you. give me all of it. But yeah, so I've been putting in lots of work. But the benefit of it is now that I can build this farm. I only built one layer because I kind of want to do something that hasn't been done before, but this right here works so good. It's hard not to just go with this idea. And I like it. It's simple. Works out pretty good. But yeah, I really like the way that this path looks. And it's just big enough to where the horse can't fall through. There's no possible way that you can spin this horse around. Now if you jump off the horse, same can't be said. Alright, so yeah, the only real problem with the setup is I'm not quite sure why, but this happens just about every time. Because like there's no area for them to spawn in, I get a lot of zombies. Things way too many in here. But the more time I spend in the nether, the more we pop up in here. So I built this little gate here because this area keeps getting full after a time. So yeah, I'll show you guys my tunnel to nowhere. I needed quite a few diamonds because I went through a lot of diamonds, breaking diamond picks and repairing them and all that fun stuff. So instead of doing the mine, I just sort of came over here and dug a tunnel to infinite nowhere. And it goes on that way for a long, long ways. But that's where I got most of the cobble from that I've been using. And then I'll smelt it there in the nether using the lava. I tried to save all the lava that I could, because that's one of those things that I do use, and I use it for smelting a lot. And then I may need the obsidian later, so I kind of want to save as much of that as I can. But yeah, so everything goes pretty well. That's one, the nether project is coming along nicely. Village is looking good. And this farm, the XP farm down here with the spawner. Couldn't have done it without it. It has been a necessity. Because every time, you know, I need a pick fixed or need to do a repair, need to have XP for it. It gets expensive after a while, and that helps a lot. But yeah, I kind of wanted to go work on spawn a little bit because it's getting kind of bad there. It's kind of ugly. I want to go fix that up. But there's some more farms. I'm gonna need a lot more string. I gotta find a better way to get string. I haven't found any spider farms yet. Or spider spawners. So I have to figure out a way for that. I need a lot more wool to cover up the hoppers on the bottom before I put dogs in there. And I need to find some dogs. So yeah, big long list to do. I kind of want to get rid of this chunk here. Just all this enclosure. I don't like it. I like it all being nice and open. And I guess we'll take the horse with us. I don't want to leave them on here. They'll wander off. Make a little spot for you. Yeah, this thing's been chugging along. Plenty of iron. Let's go see if we got any slime, because we're going to be needing some more slime blocks. What am I doing? Oh, your slime's climbing around. Eh, not so much. This really doesn't work as good as the iron farm does when I'm not around here, because nothing will spawn here unless I'm here. And I really haven't spent that much time here. Not as much as I really should. But yeah, I thought about building a little something here. Setting up some more farms. Do we have another one in here? Nope. This corner over here is just in a little bit of the slime chunk. There's another one there, so every once in a while I get the slime in there. Kind of funny. Or no, that's not that one. It's the lower part that gets it in it. Yeah, actually what I want to do is I'm going to go get rid of some of that forest over there. I thought I had more. Does it look like I thought I saved another flint. No. Darn it. And no, at least I got some gravel. Let's get rid of some of this stuff. Give me flint. Give me flint. Come on. Don't make this take forever. Do I have fortune on my pick? Oh, derp. Jeez. Oh, enjoy the free derps. I give them away for free quite often. Alright, let's go burn some stuff. Yeah, if you're wondering the reason I'm burning, it's because I don't really need this wood. But it's a lot easier for me to light it up and look around it. It's all burnt to a crisp. And this is how I've been clearing out most of this area here. As you can see by the leftover random floating wood blocks there. Damn, my frames are probably going to drop here. Yeah, little frame drop. Burn. But that's all she wrote for the burning for now. Yeah, that worked. That's so much faster than trying to cut down all the trees by myself. I like it. Hickory smoked goodness. Yeah, we'll still have some leftovers that we gotta get rid of, but I get rid of most of it. And then we're left with this big area that we can work with. But yeah, another thing that I really need to find is I need to find, like, with the glass that I used on the wither farm there. I am extremely low on sand now. Like, I've been searching out around the village there, the little sandbars like that right there, and pretty much destroyed most of those. That, and I've been getting the gravel off the ocean floor. Been using that for the pathways. But yeah, without the trees, it's a lot easier to see like what's lit up properly and what's not. So I get this all lit up, then I'll have better spawn rates at my farm there. Yeah, I'd like to eventually clean this up, make it not look like an iron golem farm. And then maybe put... I'd like to have another one around here. You know, like I put one on in the spawn chunks that way, one that way, one over there. If I can keep them on the spawn chunks and be just far enough away from each other, that'd be nice. But as far as it goes, I mean, this one here, it gives me plenty of iron. I mean, I've already got my beacon set up, and probably by the time I get another beacon, it'll be ready. And it'll have enough blocks to give me another beacon. Yeah, so let's go back over to the village and try to get some work done on getting a little market set up, as that's still burning. Thinking next time I want to start working on getting a pumpkin farm set up so we can get some emeralds going and get some villagers trading. Or maybe work on the market over there. We'll figure it out. But yeah, that's going to be it for today. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.